Okay, I'm on the other side of the creek today. Well, that logging was over on that side. The creek's down there. Camping down there. I'm gonna get some fishing done today. This little creek hardly ever gets fished because it's a real bitch to get into here. As you can see, I'm way up here. The creek's way down there. So I'm gonna make my way over that way and then try to get down to the creek and hopefully get some great shots on some dry fly fishing on trout that rarely see a fly. All right, I made it down. I don't think many people have been here this year. I haven't seen one footprint at all on the trail. You can call it a trail. Beautiful water right here. No way to get up from that side. Pretty much in a valley now for about, I'm gonna say 5K. And it's pool after pool, just like that. Let you know how it goes. So I just got here, got set up. I always like to sit and watch the creek for a half hour or so while I get geared up. I just take my time and watch and have a look at the insects and see what's going on. I didn't see any rises, but anyway, here I'm just about ready to get going. I dropped one in there and immediately had a big one come right out of there. First cast. And then I got a little one. Big one I spooked. I pulled it out of his mouth. Small one, I landed him. So anyway, yeah, they're going to be biting here today by the looks of it. I'm going to try to get a shot here. This is the nice pool, the first nice pool. You can see it there. So I'm going to try to get it set up and see if you can't see one of these big cutthroats taking the dry fly.
The one I missed. first one I missed was big. He was right where you think he'd be, right in front of that rock there. But usually when you miss a big one like that, you don't get a shot at another one. To get another one like that, decent size, what was that, 12 inch?
Okay, I just caught a couple out of there. Let's see if I can get this on video. They're pretty hungry, so if I get one right up at the front there, there might be one up there. Oh yeah, that's a good one. Oh, and he got off. Shoot.
Look at that beautiful piece of water. And the fishing's so good. You got pool after pool like that. It's easy to forget to look around and realize how beautiful this place is.
Look at that beautiful pool.
Yep, look way up. That sacred rock right up there where I was last night. Incredible. There's another bigger bull trout in there chasing him around.
A monster.
Got 5x tippet on here. Trying to break me off on the rocks. Oh, he's off. Oh. Oh. Oh my God, I'm still shaking. That was absolutely crazy. Caught a small cutthroat right in there. I just thought I'd let him go for a little while and see what happens. Sure enough, a giant bull trout grabbed him. 24 inch plus, like 5 pounds at least. Somehow, when he was attacking the cutthroat, he got the fly in his mouth, and the cutthroat either went in his belly, or I don't know, maybe he ate it and then the fly was in his mouth, I don't know, but I had that bull trout on and I battled him in here for about 5 minutes and then he just ended up getting off. He was going in and out of these rocks and there was an even bigger bull trout that was chasing him around and trying to eat him. It was insane. Monsters in there. There's a nice cutthroat. Right on the dry fly. It's gotta be, oh shoot, this good 14, maybe 16. Look at the size of that guy.
All right, I'm ready to head back. There's the creek. This is really the first place that you can get out from where I started this morning at, what time was it? Probably about 10, 11. It's now 6 o'clock. So yeah, it's been a long, hard day fishing, but really good. I had that giant bull trout on, oh Lord. Huge. And I caught a good 16 inch plus cutthroat and a whole bunch of 14s and a whole bunch of 12s and more 10s and dinks than I could count. So it was a pretty good day, I'd say. Unfortunately, I gotta climb a giant hill now and do about a 5K hike. Here we go.